So I'm here today with Wes Trochlil, who's president of Effective Database Management, and we are going to talk about business intelligence. Now, Wes, you are passionate about business intelligence. Give us your definition of BI.
My definition of business intelligence is BI is a management process for using data to make decisions. So there's just three simple elements. It's a process, so it's not an event. It's something you do over time. You use data, so we're not just using our gut. We're actually using data from our databases. And we're going to use that data to make decisions about how we do things going forward.
So now you say that many organizations are reluctant to implement BI. Tell us why. You've got a theory about this.
Yeah, I think after talking to a lot of association executives about it, talking to consultants, talking to the vendors, I think fear is the major factor here. There's a fear of doing it wrong. There is a fear of contradicting conventional wisdom, meaning that we would find something out from the BI that actually doesn't fit our typical narrative. And then the third fear is the fear of actually having to take action on that business intelligence.
So what if you've got a VP of marketing, or VP of convention marketing, and this is how he's always wanted to do it. And, I mean, there's a real fear to that, right? Like,
right.
The data shows that, you know, mailing with this type of message isn't as effective. So how do you counter that?
Well, I think that's why we use the data, because we have to make a kind of a rational argument that we can show in the data that this process works and this process does not. And then you have to, of course, tap into the emotional, which is to convince that person that, you know, we're going to have a very successful change in how we do things, which will result in either better attendance or a higher quality event or whatever the objective is.
Now, give us an example of an organization that really did a great job with BI. They learned a lot. They made changes.
Sure. One of my favorite examples is from the Texas Medical Association. A couple years ago, they implemented a new association management software system, and they said, let's take this opportunity to look at all the data that we have. And along the way, one of the things they discovered was, along with many other things, they had a third-party insurance program that requires membership in the Texas Medical Association to be participating in this third-party program. And they discovered that they had close to 1,000 doctors participating in the insurance program who were not members of TMA. And so just by comparing those lists, they discovered, we've got these 1,000 doctors, we're going to go out to them and say, look, you have to be a member if you want to keep playing in the insurance area. And most of those doctors actually renewed their membership. The result for TMA was about $500,000 to the top line.
And it was money that was being left on the table otherwise.
That's exactly right.
Wow. So how does an organization get started with BI?
I think the first thing I would recommend is, if you're using an off-the-shelf software from an association management software company, talk to your vendor. Find out what they have in terms of business intelligence tools, and learn from them perhaps some best practices for how to implement. And then the other key, which I think is really critical, and the vendor would probably tell you this, is there needs to be an internal champion for the business intelligence program. Most people are going to perceive this as, oh, that's one more thing I have to do. There's great value in doing it, but they are going to see it as, well, it's adding more to my job. So you've got to have someone internally at the association who says, I'm passionate about business intelligence. I want this to happen. And they can take the lead on that.
Now, Wes, you blog about this. How can we find you online?
I'm at effectivedatabase.com, and /blog will take you to my blog.
Excellent. Thank you so much.
Thanks for watching The Matrix Minute. Don't forget to connect with us on our blog and social media. For more information, go to matrixgroup.net.